Hello for Friday, February 3rd. You can see on Thursday we had a pretty tight range, just a little teeny candle here on the Dow, and it closed down 11.05, but you note that the volume was lower. That's exactly what we like. If it's not moving up, if it closed in the red, you like to see it lower volume, and when it closed in the green, you like to see higher volume. So far, so good. And on the SPX, it actually closed up, not much, just a little bit. You can see here up $1.45, up above that second measured move line. It got there yesterday as well, just a little bit. If you look at the futures, you can see what the range was for the day. Here we've got the Dow. You can see this is the first, and then the second began right about here. And we moved up, came back down below the pivot, then above the pivot, didn't get up to R1 at all, not even close to it, not even back to the 127.2 that it ran to last time, came back down. So now it did break through this this real short-term trend, but then it moved right back up again. So you can see we haven't drawn a line, but you could draw a little parallel channel that's going in now. And once again, if that just continues down a little bit without any, doesn't break below the low of the day, then we could see a breakout above what it, this undrawn channel, and a move back up to the upside. If we look at the S&P futures, you see it's a little different in that it had run, as you know, from yesterday up to the 161.8 projection. That's off of this top, this high here, this low to this high. Ran up to there, didn't go back up above it. Tight range in the day. Once again, that's a possible flag. Here we have this like flag pole. It came up and it's flagging in here. We could break to the upside. If we do, then we're looking at 1333, and then a possibility of 1337 as well. Watch your RSI. Note how it's tending down. You could draw a line, and if it breaks above that, that would be a good sign as well. And we'll take a look at TNA because we know several people trade that. If you're trading the Russell and not trading futures, then you can trade the 3X. Some like prefer the 2X. But just showing, we posted this chart during the day also, just showing that this is a 120-minute chart. This been in this all year. It's been within this channel. And today it ran up to the top of the channel, and people are watching it, of course, and when it gets to the top, they think, well, that's probably it, and so they sold, and it came off, but it's got a little flag going for it now, and that's a possibility of continuation from there. Okay, what else do we have here? We have got, we'll take a look at the dollar, I think. We can see how it did. Down after a couple days going up a little bit, it came down, but not enough that it, really the market cared much about it. In fact, lately the market's been going up as the dollar's been going down, so that's a little change of how it was in the past, as you know, that quite often had done that. Just when the dollar dropped, you could count on the market going up. But gold continues just a little bit higher, little by little. Not a great volume on that, but that is good because also the gold miners, so GDX. That, of course, has been along quite a while, and it gained another 91 cents, closing at 57.47. And SLV is also long as silver, still doing well, and it closed up about 59 cents at 33.35. Okay, so now let's take a look at some of the stocks that happened during the day, and I think we'll show first off what a lot of stocks... I'll show you that in a moment. I wanted to show you, I was going to show you GLUU just to show how stocks just keep on going. That's why we've said all year that this has just been a fantastic market. And this is just another example. We spoke about MIPS. This broke out last week, actually it broke out Tuesday. And we posted that it's getting, be cautious as it gets close to that 200-day to see if it can break above. Well, it did break above, and now it's totally above the top Bollinger Band, going up another 6%. So great move for it. And look at how many days it ran up, even since, you know, it ran up from the end of December and then dropped a little bit and then ran right back up again. This would be a measured move. We have not measured it out here, but you can do this height and then add it on from this low going up. So it looks like it's got a little bit more on the upside to complete that measured move. Remember, the rare earths did well a couple days ago. Then they pulled back, and you can see like AVL pulled back right to support, so it gave you the second chance to buy. It pulled back on lighter volume, and then it ran up another 6%. So anyone watching that could pick up on that pretty easily. Not a bad situation. We also posted that and REE in the morning because it looked like this would be breaking above that 200-day, which it did, and then broke above that 737 and continued up nicely as well. Not as big a volume as it was before. It's getting over the top band, but nice move. Now, if it does go another day or so and then pulls back, if it can hold that 200-day, then that'd be a point to buy because you can always put a stop just underneath that. WFR was a new buy, triggering finally over the top here. And so that's doing well. Also at increased volume there. VRTX, Vertex, you can see just the volume's a little bit above normal, but it did break out above this line, not above the top intraday line, but above our little breakout line here, and it still has room to run even to get up to the top Bollinger Bands. And COCO, Corinthian College, continued its move higher. Great move, also increased big volume. But I wouldn't think that it's going to go 3 days. It's a possibility, but keep your stops pretty tight because going up this much in just a couple of days, 30%, then 6%, so it's going to pull back sooner or later. Okay, let's look at additions to the watch list now. And first, I see why. We're going to show you GLUU. This and MIPS did the same, but this I'm saying there's so many stocks that are just like this. Not like in December when we have a breakout and then they pull back and then they pull back under the breakout line. Eventually they might go up. These are just hitting, keep on hitting. So now it's up above the top. This isn't on the watch list, just showing that how many days in a row, 3, 6, 7 days in a row, up. And that, so when they start, don't be too nervous about it if they don't have big volume. Once they get going, sometimes that's when people finally decide to get in, versus in December, people decide to get in, and then the next day, no one's interested. This month, all month, people just want to buy. And they look at a strong stock and they buy. This is one ACHN from the chat room. It was talked about. It was moving from, you can see our lower line here. It's moving up from there. So a lot of folks bought it. You can see the volume. It did 2.7 million shares. Pretty clear one to see is this breaking above this with the long red candle on the left. So where did it run to? Up to the top of the long red candle on the left. That's a very common thing when it's not too big a move. So is here, there, now. So we thought, let's just add it again. Eventually over that 1246, you know, in the past also, we would want to trade these because they've just gone up 11%. Well, the chance of them going again right in this market, they could do it. Or it could pull back like we saw with REE and AVL and then move later. But it looks like that's going to continue. Anyway, ALIM. Now we're showing two views of this. First, and this is what you should do with all the charts, go to the watch list page where you can actually click on the chart. And then underneath the chart, you can change the time setting. It's a fast way to look back and see what's coming up. If you just see the close-up, which you will in a minute, you wouldn't see what's going on over here. So it's almost like a gap coming to this area. So if it does and breaks above the $2 area, the 50-day EMA, and then a little bit above, then it's got this long candle. It could move up pretty quickly if it can break above that line. But anyway, that's to pay attention to because it's several months in the making. And it may not be able to, but when it breaks, especially if it's coupled with some news, it could be moving up for short-term reasons. About the $1.73 was the high. You could trade up to this next level or above the 185, going up to the 2. So that's just showing it. You can do with it how you like. LinkedIn probably is getting a little notice, or some people are thinking about it because they're thinking now about the Facebook IPO, and LinkedIn, of course, had dropped a lot since its IPO. It's overpriced now. 77.84 would be a top. This is the high of the day, so it could break out yet again. There you can see what resistance in the past November to look at on the left. DEPO is a possibility over about $6.40. There you can see it. That was a high of the day. 647 was an intraday spike high, but did have improved volume, which suggested it could go. Also note that it does have a golden cross with the 50-day moving up over the 200. Oh, I'm sorry. That's a 20-day. Take that back. That's a good sign, though. That is a cross. It is a moving average cross. The 50-day is still down here. But still, when you've got those, that resulted in a big move, and this may continue. LII is up next, over $39.03. That was its high of the day. And you can see it was good volume on Wednesday, not as good on Thursday, but bigger move on Thursday. And it also had this 20-day moving up over the 200-day. RSE, we're adding this as well, over about $13.10 with a long candle on the left. That could mean maybe a 90-cent move if it does, if it's able to go back up and test that $14 high. DVR, I think we're going to call this, we gave it a price of 226. I don't know why we were thinking, just call it a continuation. But you can see it at increased volume. It's been consolidating this pattern. Do pay attention. We remind you each day during earnings season, do check on earnings. You look at a pattern like this, nothing to hold it back, but remember, they might report earnings and maybe they'll drop from here. SGY, Stone Energy, over $30.20, had improving volume on Thursday. It looks good, like it could move up as well. And note that it does have its moving averages all in a row. We have the 20, then the 50, and then the 200, just like we want to see stocks that we're on the long side, if possible. And lastly, we have WBS, $22.20. That would be the high. So it's broken above this 22.05. But lately, that doesn't keep people from rushing in, and hopefully they will do that as well. So that's what we have for Friday. I hope you have a great day trading. You know, it's a weekend, so we'll have a newsletter out. It's free. Go to StockTiger.net. Up at the top right-hand section, you'll see a place to put your email address, and you'll get that newsletter out on the weekend. Have a great weekend wherever you are. Most of the country, a good share of it, has no snow at all. Some parts do, but so it's like springtime. Enjoy it while it lasts, at least. And we will be sending tweets out during Friday and also sometime during the weekend also. So do pay attention to those. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll talk to you soon. Bye-bye.